So this is your medical team, and this is the relationship of the medical team relative to the injuries. Now, having said that, how do you select the medical team? What does a medical team mean? Well, basically, it means them supporting you and not hurting you. That's what it means. So how to select a medical team? So you can see here it says, how do you get in? Well, all you do is you get a list of those local providers, whether it's a pain management specialist, whether it's a neurosurgeon or a neurologist or a neuropsychologist. You just Google them, find the ones you've already worked with in the past and that you've had a mutual patient with, and make a short list of those, and then have your staff member call, and you want to meet them personally. You don't want to just do this over the phone. You want to meet them. And how you get in is you tell them it's for their benefit. So it's you're interested in referring patients to their business. That's how you get in. In other words, they're going to benefit. And so you want to tell them how they're going to benefit. That is your message to get in the door and meet the doctor. Okay. So how it would sound like is I'd have that short list that I told you about with each of these different providers. And my staff member would call and say, hey, this is Dr. So-and-so's office, and he's looking to refer patients to your office. But before he does that, he would just like to briefly stop by and introduce himself. And that's what we want. Now, you do not want to ask for a lunchtime or a meeting time or none of that. It's just real quick. Everybody's busy. So you just want to stop by for 10 minutes and introduce yourself. You're interested in referring patients to this practice, but before you refer practice, you want to meet them and you'd like to introduce yourself. That is exactly what you say. That's how you're going to get the meeting. Now, when you get the meeting, there's three big questions that you have to get answered. Remember, there's two reasons why we want this medical team. Number one is so they don't hurt us. Number two is so they support us. Now, unfortunately, too many times, if you don't do what I just said and vet, we're vetting who we're going to do business with. And these are the three questions that I use to vet that provider. So when I meet them, I introduce myself and I just say, by the way, what have you heard about chiropractic? I ask an open-ended question and I shut up. And I'm just listening. Now, what I'm listening for is any type of negativity. You know, I don't believe in this, or I don't, you know, just like sharp negativity. What you can be assured you won't get is you will not get somebody that's going to be blowing the horn of chiropractic and how it's great for everything and asthma, allergies, and ear infections and bedwetting, and man, it should just be the cream de la cream. You're not going to get that. So, you know, you're going to get some passe, if anything, you know, the people that are pro chiropractic. It'll be very limited. They'll say, yeah, chiropractic is good for some types of back pain. I mean, that's going to be the limit of what you're going to, and that's totally fine. That's what you want. What you don't want, what you do not want, is somebody who is antagonist to chiropractic or is negative to chiropractic. That's what you're looking for first, because the worst thing that can happen is question number two and number three is, and actually number three, if you don't do this, and you just refer somebody, and if you've been in practice any time at all, you already know this, and you refer a patient to somebody, and you have not vetted them, you can be guaranteed you're going to get your career pretty fast, but that person that you just referred that business to is now saying negative things about chiropractic, and they will take them off the treatment schedule. Now, this is how they take them off the treatment schedule, not to offend you. Here's what they say to the patient. Well, let's hold off on chiropractic until you feel better. I mean, it's like an oxymoron. It's like crazy. But that's their way of discriminating against you without you being able to sue them, because that's their opinion. Everybody has their opinion. You can't sue for an opinion. So this is what you want to do. The first thing is know you're not dealing with a hostile person. Now, the second question that I ask is, I'd be interested in referring you business. if you agree not, if, and I always say this, if you agree to two factors, number one, you agree not to say anything negative about chiropractic to the patients that are referred to you. And I always like to say this, just as I would never say anything about your profession if I saw one of your patients. And by saying that, it's kind of an equalizer. It's kind of like a no-brainer. So that's how I like to say it. So I'd be interested in referring you patients under two circumstances. Number one, if you'd be willing to agree that you would not say anything negative about chiropractic to the patients that I refer here, just as I would never say anything negative to any patients that I would see that was yours. Would you be willing to agree to that? That's what that would sound like. Number two, remember, you're holding the cards. You're not asking him for anything. Right now, you're holding all the cards of all the deck. You're interviewing him, okay? So you're in the position of power. This is, you're not asking for anything right now. Number two is that you agree not to take him off my treatment schedule, just like I wouldn't take any of your patients if I happen to see him off their treatment schedule. Would you be willing to agree to that? That's exactly how it's said. So the very first thing that I'm trying to do with these providers is vet them and see if there's any hostility or a huge negativity. And then I just want an agreement. Don't screw with me, buddy. Don't say anything negative and don't take them out from under my care. Now, that's the three big questions. And now here's the follow-up questions. Now, remember, those are the three big emphatic questions.